Hey guys, how's it going? Today I have yet another video. Took a little break here over the last couple weeks or week. And that was just because I'm running short on content and right now I don't have much to upload. I also want to, it's going to be my 100th video with this and I just want to make it something kind of quality. So for those of you that ride motorcycles and wear full face helmets, modular helmets or anything that can kind of have the cheek pad and everything kind of removed. SENA is a company, or SENA, however you want to say it. They make motorcycle helmet comm systems. So you can listen to your phone, Bluetooth, like jam out, and then they also can connect the units individually between each other. So I had a SENA 30K before this, which was very similar to this model, which is their top end. This is now the new model, the 50S, and it has a couple new features, such as 30% faster charging. It's a USB-C charge port instead of the old micro USB. And then on top of that, it allows you to use Google and Siri, activated by voice now. It has new redesigned speakers, which are 60% louder, and they're also slimmer than the old one. The only thing I'm not going to like with this is I don't really care for the silver, not my thing. And then you can always update, or you can update this one now via Wi-Fi versus the old one you had to plug into a computer and update that way. Other than that, I know there's a couple other features. They also rolled out an update for all SENAs running mesh, and you're upgraded to the 2.0, which has 80% more data transferred. So apparently it's stronger and better. So hopefully that ends up being the case. I just updated my old 30K, which is on my secondary helmet. And I'll be putting this on my helmet here. So I'm going to show you guys how to install and what's in the box. So let's get into that. And I have no idea how this opens. So I'm assuming, there we go. Just slide her out. Boom, nice little box. Tells you all the features on the back here. And has Bluetooth 5, mesh intercom 2.0, up to 1.2 miles with the intercom, multi-way intercom, music sharing, advanced noise control, audio multitasking, voice command. I'm not going to read all that. Anyway, let's keep going here. Shake her out. Boop. Toss that over there. And here is the SENA. So nice package. So this is the basically the brains of the unit. You charge this up. The charge port is right. Oh, we're tracking a little weird here. Follow my hand. So this is the brains of the unit. There's a little charge port right here. And that is USB-C now, which is great because I have Samsung phones, so I run that charge port. And let's get it back on the box here. So that I'm just going to put off to the side. Actually, I'm going to start charging this while we do this. All right. So pop the top off here. Boom. Pull out the first and the under box on this. This is instructions. We're not going to need those. I already know how to do this. I'm a pro. So I got that over there. So in this box, which got a 3.5 mil aux cord. This is the charging cord with the Wi-Fi adapter. So this will update it. USB-C charging cord. Wonderful. Can never have enough of those. A bunch of your foam pads. Another mic for it, because you can swap out mics depending on your helmet. So this is another type of mic that I'm going to leave the one that's on there. And then this package right here that I'm opening is the actual piece that goes in. And I can already tell these speakers are way better than the old ones, just from fit and feel. Like the other ones feel real chintzy, and yeah, you can just, these are nicer. I don't know how they're gonna sound, but they definitely feel nicer than the other ones. But we're gonna pop this cord off here, and I'm gonna flip this helmet over and we're gonna start installing this. To install this, you're gonna need a, what size is this, third one, so 2.5 millimeter Allen key. And you just, actually I lied, it comes with one, but 2.5 mil Allen key to install this. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna unscrew these so that it's loose. You're gonna slip it in the helmet, and I'll explain that while I'm putting it on. All right, so this is the Scorpion XO R420 helmet. It's a medium in black. To install this, it's pretty simple. So I'm going to go ahead. There's three little clips that you can just kind of pop out. You just pull on it, and you're going to pull your inside cheek pads out. So I'm popping these up, and they just pull out of the lining like that. That was interesting. Whatever. And then do the same on both sides. So go ahead and pop it out. So you're going to have access to all of the inside here. Stop tracking my hand. And in my helmet, you can actually see, I don't know if you guys can see, but there's these little indents that are for SENA speakers, actually, or Cardo. And then I pop this back piece down here because I'm actually going to route the wires behind for the SENA. So I'm going to go ahead. What you're going to need, so there's in that one package I showed you, there are these boom mic windscreens. So I'm going to take one of those out for later. That goes on the boom mic that came with the SENA. I don't need that anymore. There are these spacers. So if you're, if you want to, you can actually put these spacers to push the speakers from that unit closer to your head. So I don't think I'm going to do that. We're going to do that. So we got those. And then these little Velcro pieces go onto the back of the speakers and 3M into the helmet so that you can stick your helmet in there or stick your speakers in the helmet. There are other pads in here that you could actually stick the microphone to. You can just take it in and out, or if you have modular helmets. But I'm going to go ahead and go get this tape off, and then I will show you how to get everything installed in here. Alrighty, so I've got the sticky pads off here. We are going to just stick it on the inside here, which is easier said than done. Alright, so the adhesive pieces just go in the ear cup. And then I'm going to loosen up the SENA itself here, the clamp, just with an Allen key. Just back them out quite a bit. You're going to want to be able to really open it up and get it on the helmet. So that was a decent amount. All right, so it goes on the left side of your helmet, and I'm just gonna, it's gonna go in between this mesh material and the helmet. So since I've already had one on here, it's all tangled up on the mic here. Come on. We're gonna go ahead and install it here. So mine just slides on like that. Yours is probably going to be a kind of a pain in the butt. They do include an adhesive that you could just stick to the outside of your helmet if you can't get it in this liner. But like I said, I've done one on here and I know it fits. Next, what I do is put the speakers in their spots. So the short cord goes to your left ear, obviously. And I'm already butchering this, so I'm going to actually put a spacer pad in between it. So I'm going to stick the spacer on the back of the ear. I'm going to put that right in there. And if that doesn't work, then I can always just take the spacer out real quick. But I want to see if getting it closer to my ear is going to be a problem or not. Put the other one in. And what I do is I route this cord right behind this. But for now, we're just doing that to tuck cable so we can tighten this. So now once the clamp is all the way seated, there's a little rubber kind of notch that you can't go past. Go ahead and tighten it up. tighten each one a little bit at a time here. So what you're wanting to do is get these screws real snug because you don't want this main part kind of moving around on the helmet. And that one's getting tight. So I'll come back with you guys after I finish tightening this up and then show you the process after this. Alrighty, so I've got my clamp tight on here. So the next step is route these wires on the back that are going to the back speaker and all that under the back of your helmet pad liner. Keep the straps out of the way. So I'm going to put that one right there. Click it in. Voice crack. It's great. Shove the other one right there. That's all clicked in now. What I'm going to do is keep one of those, or both wires raised over here, and insert the original liner as I put, does this one go over here? Yep. Okay, so you just go ahead and start putting your cheek pads back in. I like to do the boom mic through here. Put on the wind muff, which just slides on. It has little hooks on the mic that actually help keep the windscreen, whatever you want to call it, from sliding off, which is nice. This is always tricky too, depending on your helmet. These might be a real snug fit, so just go ahead and start guiding everything into its places. Always do the hard side first because then it's just way nicer to have the easy side done. Okay, come on. And for those of you wondering, why do I run the mic through the emergency pad? Because quite frankly, I don't think I'm ever going to need it to be emergency released. And if that comes down to being the case, this mic will be able to be ripped off in an emergency. So then you can just tuck your mic up here. And I'm going to feel, is that speaker too far out? Doesn't feel like it, but we'll find out. And go ahead and clip. So I'm going to go ahead and install the other cheek pad, and then when I'm done with that, I'm going to give you guys an audio test on the 50S versus the 30K, because I do have the 30K still, and that is installed in my old helmet. So we'll give you guys kind of a first listen and see if you can tell the difference with a 30K versus 50S, and we'll have you guys guess which one's which. So yeah. Alright, so what are my thoughts? So we got the 50S versus the 30K. I have both. Personally, I like the styling on the 30K a little bit more. But sound-wise on the speakers, the 50S speakers are phenomenal. That being said, the 30K is still a phenomenal unit. For the price, I think you're getting more bang now for what you get with the 50S, considering it's only like 20 bucks more expensive. But if you want the all black, get the 30K. They both have identical footprints. I believe they weigh the same. The 30K gets the new 2.0 for mesh, so you can still communicate with the 50S. So there's really no downside to getting either one. The speakers alone are what I got the 50S for. They do sound phenomenal. But yeah, overall, I hope it's a great unit. The gasket that actually attaches the pins and the unit to the helmet is a lot nicer with the 50S, and that's noted. So hopefully it's a better water resistance. I never had an issue, but just in case. But yeah, if you guys are looking to get a SENA, I'll give a little mesh 2.0 overview and let you guys know how that goes in the comments. But yeah, these are, I like SENA, whatever you want to say, but I actually like their units. I don't have any friends that run Cardos, so I run a SENA, and I have no issues with them. I've rode in, with my 30K, I've rode in hail, snow, freezing fog, rain, super windy conditions, just everything, and it's held up well. So I don't know. For those of you that have issues with them, I'm sorry, but I've never had an issue. So I'll be sticking with SENA for a while. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and hopefully I made your decision with this unit a little bit easier. They're both great units. The 50S has those nice features, the USB-C and stuff like that. So if you guys do like these videos, drop a comment telling me what you want to see more of. Hit that like button and subscribe if you aren't already. Thanks, guys.